know, God can bless us and give us that double portion. And, you know, we got a lot of needs that we know we need to see met. And we've got lost souls that lost that we need to see saved.
Amen.
And people that's, you know, confused and, you know, sick in their mind. But you know, they need Jesus.
Amen.
And, you know, on this way they can be, we just have to be a light to them, even though they may walk a mile not to speak to you. But then we need to walk 2 miles to speak to them.
Amen.
And that's hard to do sometimes, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
When people do you wrong, you got to show kindness, you got to forgive them. And if they don't forgive you, that's up to them and the Lord. Because we got to have a perfect heart. We got to love. And we can't win no lost souls if we got to hate or got something against somebody. We can't show no love. Because, you know, God is love.
Uh-huh.
And we have to let our light shine and to be a blessing. And for them to, you know, be a blessing, then they will be a blessing to us. And in some way, you know, if you show love overcomes the people that make them feel condemned. I know, she claimed me so mighty, and dressed, no white pants and stuff like that. And, you know, she, when I go by, she turn her head. But one day if she was there, I was gonna speak to her. I just gonna show them, you know. Because, you know, we got to break the spirit, you know, because it's something matter. Because, like you said, she knows me. I mean, you know, not personal. Like, y'all each other during the meeting. We've been together in meetings and stuff like that. But there ain't no sense in nobody acting like that. I mean, if you claim to be a Christian, you ain't no better. We save by grace. And as long as we ain't got no sin, but and pray daily, then, you know, we belong to Jesus. Mm-hmm. A lot of people preach against you. You drink coffee, it's a sin. You drink Coke, it's a sin. You watch TV, throw it out the door. Because that was a sin to them, they was watching something they shouldn't.
Yeah.
And then they think that you should, and then they condemn you. But see, man don't condemn you. God does. When God condemns you, then you better get rid of it. You know, man, you tried and tried to be the head, but Jesus is the head.
That's right.
That's what's the matter with the world today. People try to tell you how to do, what to eat, how to go, where to go, and Jesus is the head. It's listening
right.
To him.
Amen.
He's the only one that we need to be listening to, Jesus.
That's right.
And people preach the word, then follow the word. Not man doctrine, because they can lead you wrong.
Amen.
But Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life, and I want to be led by him. I want to hear his voice, and I want to be obedient to him. Now, a lot of times, you know, sometimes we want to do things, and the Lord say no. But old flesh say yeah. Now, sometimes, you know, you just have that wrestle against that flesh, because he wants to do his own, because he try to overcome the spirit. But if we got Jesus in us, we had to rebuke that spirit. And take our stand over the devil. But I praise God that, you know, that I ask the Lord just to help me each day. And I pray each day. You know, people say they don't sin. But, you know, the Bible said to pray daily, and he forgive us 70 times 70. So if people didn't sin every day, he wouldn't put that in there. So he know we weren't going to be perfect. He knows that he gave us a place to repent. Then if we don't repent and you just keep doing it and keep doing it, then it's a sin. But God give us a chance to repent. He give us a chance to be obedient to him, where he can use us, where he can trust us. Mighty God, I feel the Holy Ghost.
Bless you.
Because he lives within me, Brother Bob. And I don't listen to man if they preach the word, but I listen to God.
Amen.
I listen to Jesus.
Yes.
Let's just give Jesus a hand praise
Amen.
Today. Well, we thank the Lord for ever who she is, and I know Linda, she must something.
Remember her.
Remember them. And remember all my family and my grandson, and remember my granddaughter, and just remember me that I'll be ever obedient to the Lord. Anybody else got a spoken request?
Remember Mitchell Smallwood's grandson Gunner? I'm not for sure, but I've got to get in back contact with him, but they thought two or three days ago, they thought he had the COVID-19. He's just like, 5 years old?
5 years old.
5 years old. So just remember him. Either way, he needs prayer, you know.
Just remember that.
Him and remember Sister Linda. I think I texted her Friday, and she's still pretty bad sick. Said she was freezing, her legs was freezing and hurting. Really don't sound too good, you know. She's been that way over a week.
Yeah.
So just remember her. Remember her.
Anybody else?
Let's remember Madison.
Yes.
They're supposed to pull up at the end of the day. Let's remember him.
Yes.
Remember my wife, my lost loved ones, even my saved loved ones, and remember Freddie too, because he's had a lot to come against him. Remember him.
Remember him. With the unspoken request, just raise your hands and stand to your feet. We're just going to pray. Lord, we just come to you, Lord. We bring every request, Lord, that was given in to you, Lord. Lord, we just pray, Lord Jesus, that the one that's sick, one that need help, one that need to be delivered, need to be saved, mighty God, need to come back home, Lord, and be a family, Lord. We pray, mighty God, to move for each and every one, every request given in, one that's sick, mighty God, one that is upset and discouraged, and Lord Jesus, you know their needs, Lord. We pray, Lord Jesus, just to move on each and every one. Bring them in. Save their souls. In the mighty name of Jesus. And we give you the praise in Jesus' holy name. Let's give Jesus a hand clap. Glory to God. Well, the people that sings tonight are going to have to double up, sing 4 or 5. And Bob, you're going to have to sing tonight. You can't shake your head that way. You have to be like this. Oh, you know, it's good. The life is just like medicine, ain't it? So I needed some medicine tonight.
Amen.
So I guess we all need medicine.
Amen.
Because we need the life, because you go through things, and sometimes it pulls you down, and we just need to have that joy. And you know, when we come to church, we ought to have that joy, that peace, and you know, just give the devil a black eye, because he's been trying to give us one, ain't he? But he's been missing me. He's been trying to, Brother Fred. But I've been dodging. Sometimes we got to dodge, don't we?
Yeah.
Oh, praise the Lord. I'm going to ask Rachel. She's shaking her head a different way. You put the feet. She's not even smart. Oh. Well, sometimes you just don't feel like it, but well, anybody else, Bob, you want to sing now?
I'll let somebody else go first.
Well, it's left up to Annie Ken. Rachel, I didn't mean nothing by that.
I know.
Anybody got a testimony? Want to testify for Candy and Ann getting a phone?
I just want to thank God for, you know, the blessings that He's given us. You know, I've not had a COVID-19, and I know it's all because of God, you know, because I don't wear a mask whenever I go out. And I just want to thank Him, glorify His name.
Some places they make you wear a mask. I had to wear couple of times in places, and but I mean, you know, you had to wear them, so I had to put it on.
Just a close to walk with him. That there.
You don't see Dave.
But I mean, it's just, is that their rule, you know, you have to obey them, you know, or you won't be getting no shopping.
Number two.
But look, like, you know, people think you're going to rob somebody, somebody has to put my mask on.
Thank you.
You may have to pull it out, put it back in, see if that straightens it out.
Thank you. so much thanking for.
Praise the Lord, everybody. I guess it's Bob time. Let's give Jesus a hand clap. Appreciate him, the Lord. Appreciate everyone that obeyed the Lord and sang and you know, to be part of the service. We all need to obey God if we're going to get a blessing. And so we need each other in this hour and this time. We need to pray for one to another because we don't know what tomorrow may bring.
Right.
Just take one day at a time. And I started on this journey years ago, and I always said, take one day at a time because we don't know what tomorrow may bring. Just praise the Lord. Thank him and for his brought me from, and I'm still on that rock. And sometimes we might kind of get sick and fall off, but we can get back on it. Hear that old song, you know, climbing up that mountain on the way home. And sometimes we do climb, don't we? And sometimes we fall, and we had to keep on the climbing. But one of these days, we're going to get to the top. We're going to make it by the help of God. We're going to make it. You know, you can't give up when you have a little problem and something goes wrong. And you know, a lot of people think, well, God going to answer it. Sometimes God says no, mm-hmm. you know. And a lot of people don't like God says no. But, you know, we had to be obedient to God. And sometimes it's no. Sometimes he answers prayer, but sometimes he's got his own time. Mm-hmm. And we just have to be patient and wait upon the Lord.
I'm not up there yet. Hey, they're just
trying to start spawning out.
I said, listen, we're tired, everybody lagging, we're getting this going.
Trying to rush me.
I think this is pretty good. 2 weeks in.
Have you been praying? So many years, have you been hoping that things would have changed by now? Have you cried all the faith you have through so many tears? Don't forget the things that he has done before, and remember he can do it all.
God is laying it on me to pray, to
was there the moment that it happened, but you couldn't see me through the pain. I caught every tear as they were falling when you lost your heart that day. Yeah, you lost your heart that day. Now you only see through broken lenses, trying to keep your head above the shame. You believe the lie that I am distant, but I hold you every day. Yeah, I hold you every day. If you could see it through my
I usually wouldn't talk, but you know, thank God that them chains have been broken, you know. And I come out of them chain, and sometimes people say, well, I can't keep your mouth shut. I said, well, God set me free. So, you know, when you get free, then you're happy, ain't you? Yeah. People used to say, well, you know, they said, when we first started the church, they said, well, they called me and Lucy dishwashers. You know, we had to, you know, you have a revival, and you know, everybody was, you know, at the church, they would go, they would eat. Well, me and Lucy, we would go in and help fix the sandwich and fix the coffee or the drinks and stuff. And then that just ended up in the kitchen. Me and Lucy looked at each other one day. I said, we said, well, we ain't no dishwasher. We're not no sandwich maker. We just didn't put it to God and them. But they were just pushing us right in the kitchen, you know, the other preacher's wives. And so we just happened, the Lord worked it out to give us the wisdom how to do it and not make nobody mad. But you know, sometimes people will use you. Mm-hmm. They will use you. So we had to, but we know you got to have wisdom to know how to do it and not make nobody mad. Because you know, you don't need nobody mad in church yet. When you come to church and everybody's mad at each other, and that'd be bad, wouldn't it? Somebody mad for I've been to them churches, ain't you? This side will be mad against this side, and this will be mad against that one. Well, Lord, how much help can God move? In confusion. That is confusion, isn't it? Mm-hmm. And he's not the author of confusion. And I'm glad that, you know, each day from where I started from, where I'm at today, God has given me wisdom and more wisdom. And I ask God, I need more wisdom. And this last day, Brother Bob, we need more wisdom. Because people will use you, people will lie on you, they don't want you to be blessed. They want to keep you down all the time. But God wants us to be lifted up and to be happy and to know we're on the winning side. Uh-huh. So let's just give Jesus a hand praise and stand to your feet when you get to your billfold and get to your money. I'm going to ask God, Grandma Bob, we're going to ask the blessing over the offering. Lord, we pray in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord. One to have to give, Lord, we ask you to bless it. One that don't have to give, ask you to bless the Lord. Ask you to bless the offering, Lord Jesus. Supply every need of this church, mighty God. Ask you to bless it, Lord Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, we give you the praise. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
God is good. Lord, we thank you for the offering, Lord. We pray, Lord Jesus, and bless it, Lord Jesus. And Lord, multiply it, Lord. The one that didn't have to give, bless them, Lord. And we give you the praise in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, I want everybody to stand. And I want you to stretch your hand towards the prayer box. Because there's a lot of things in you that a lot of needs. Black sliders. People talks about people, run people down. Some of them, you know, has blasphemed. Some of them needs help. Some of them suicide. Mighty God, we need you. I want you to stand to your feet. And I want you to lift your hands and ask God to have mercy on some of these people in here, Lord. Lord Jesus, we pray, Lord, for this prayer box. Lord, this prayer box been here for years. And Lord, there's a lot of names in you that we don't even know what you do, Lord. You know every name, every one that needs help, needs healing, needs deliverance, one that talks too much, Lord. Lord, we pray, Lord Jesus, that one that blackslides, one that's sick, Lord, the home separated, Lord. We ask you, Lord Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus, to bless the prayer box, Lord, and save them and deliver them. Bring them back in, Lord. Let them to be saved, mighty God. Lord, we give you the praise and the honor in Jesus' holy name. Mighty God, let's give Jesus a hand clap. Glory to God. Almighty God we serve. Woo, hallelujah. He's a mighty God. He's a God of the day. He's a God of the night. He's never too busy to hear us when we pray.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Everybody stand while we ask Brother Fred. Time for Brother Fred to bring us the word of God and to tell our... Amen. Appreciate what it is. Let's give him a hand, praise.
Hallelujah.
Here come the preacher man.
Praise the Lord. Give the Lord a great big old hand clap of praise tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. How many is thankful to be alive and well tonight and in the house of the Lord? Amen.
Yes.
You know, if the devil could have, he would have killed us. If the devil could have, he would have stopped us. But you know what? He couldn't. Amen. Hallelujah. Why? Because God, he says, those that fear him, the angel of the Lord encampeth around them. Come on now. What are you saying? He takes care of his own. Amen. He watches over his own. Amen. And as long as we're in his will, we fear him, we're walking the best that we know how, upright before God. Those angels, come on now. His angel, huh, is encamped around us and keeping us. Come on, I want to encourage somebody tonight. People's opinion don't mount to a hill of beans.
Amen.
All that matters is what God thinks about you tonight.
Amen.
All that matters is the Lord pleased with you. Have you done your best, come on now, to walk in the manner that he'll have you to walk? See, brother, I can't work out your salvation. The Bible says we're to work out our own salvation with fear and trembling. I cannot work your salvation out. You can't work mine out. Come on now. Somebody need to hear me tonight. And it also teaches us, glory to God, about judging folk. Come on. Now there's a righteous judgment, but there's an unrighteous judgment. Huh? What did he say? He said for you to get the beam out of your own eye, so that you can see clearly to get the mote out of your brother's eye. What does he say? Get the log out of your own eye so you can see clear enough to get the splinter out of your brother's eye. Come on now. See, there's a thing about it. If you're going to pass judgment on somebody, you better make sure your own house is clean. Huh? You better make sure there's no skeletons in your closet. Because God will expose you also.
That's right.
Mm. My. Somebody need to hear me tonight. We got too many that's living in the self-righteous, holier-than-thou spirit. They're strung out on pills. They're strung out on everything. But they're judging everybody else.
Amen. Come on.
Huh? They're passing that judgment on everybody else.
They are.
Come on. And they need to get the log out of their own eye first.
Amen.
Huh? You can't help nobody if you run around with a log in your eye. I can't help you if I got a big old log. Most of the time, the ones that's tearing down others is the ones that's hiding things themselves. And it makes them feel better, Bobby, if they can tear you down. Makes them feel better about themselves if they can tear you down. But let me encourage somebody tonight. Don't listen to them. Turn a deaf ear.
Mm-hmm.
Huh? Come on, turn a deaf ear. Because you got to know this. God is not the author of confusion.
Amen.
He's not the author of it. But he is at peace. Mm-hmm. Huh? I feel peace tonight. I feel peace in this building tonight. I feel peace. There's no confusion here tonight. There's no division here tonight. There's no separation here tonight. But there's unity in the Spirit. Come on now, somebody need to hear me. And where there's unity at, God can flow. Where there's unity at, the gifts can flow. Where there's unity at, glory to God, people can be touched, brother. People can be set free. Come on now. They can have peace of mind. They can have peace of heart. Where there's unity. Huh? Oh, come on. How many loves him tonight? I want you to be encouraged. Yeah, I preach against sin, folks. You better believe I do. But let me tell you something. Every once in a while, God's people need encouraged. They need lifted up. Huh? Let me tell you something. If you're a true child of God, if you're truly born again, you're going to know not to sin. Am I right, Sister Mary? Because the Spirit of God's on the inside. And He's going to convict you. Huh? He's going to let you know when you're doing something wrong or your intentions are wrong. Huh? He's going to let you know. He's going to. Yes, we need to preach against sin. We need to lay it out there. We need to make it known. But let the Holy Ghost do His job. I'm going to tell somebody tonight, you're not the Holy Ghost. Stop trying to clean God's people up. He said He'd make us fisher of men, but we go and catch them, and He cleans them. Come on now, somebody need to hear me tonight. We go catch them, then God, through His Spirit, the Holy Ghost, will clean them up. We've driven more people off with a self-righteous spirit and a holier-than-thou spirit when we ain't even got all our I's dotted and all our T's crossed. Huh? Acting like we all that when we ain't nothing. Come on. And we drove babes in Christ off. Let's let God do a work. They get saved this week and they're still drinking, brother. Let God do a work. Huh? He'll get a hold of them. He had to clean me up. Everything didn't go. A lot of people, well, it all went at the altar. Well, if it did, glory to God, praise God, that's good for you. But He had to clean me up. All of it didn't leave at the altar. Come on, I was forgiven, but temptation was still there. Things were still tugging at my heart. Things were still trying to pull me into the world. Come on now. Things were still in my life that shouldn't have been in it. And the Holy Ghost of God had to clean me up. He had to clean me from the inside out. Come on. Lot's worried about the outside, but he warned them, the Pharisees and them one time. He said, you're like whitened sepulchers. That's a tomb. You're like a whitened sepulchers. Come on, there, I'll preach one at the mic even on. You're like whitened sepulchers. Means they didn't even know. Praise the Lord. That ain't coming on. But praise the Lord. Like whitened sepulchers. Tombs appear all beautiful on the outside, but on the inside you're full of dead men's bones, all the uncleanness. Huh? Brother, I could take a cup, a coffee cup, we'll use that as an example, and I could wipe the outside off and it look clean, but you look inside and it'd be dirty because I didn't clean the inside. Well, here's the thing about Jesus. He works from the inside out. He does a cleaning on the inside. He gets rid of all the dead men's bones. He gets rid of all the uncleanness. But when you try to do it yourself, you grow bitter. When you try to do this yourself, you grow self-righteous. And you condemn and you judge everybody else. You condemn them into hell. You preach them into hell. Come on now. Why? Because you're bitter. You're bitter. I've been there. I know what I'm talking about tonight. Because I tried it on my own and I became bitter. I put everybody in hell. I can't do that. There's only one that can do that, Brother Bobby. That's God. Huh? He's the only one that's got the power to cast them into hell. I can't do that. I can tell you what the Word says. I can tell you the Word says your life ain't right. But I can't pass judgment and say you're not going to make it because somewhere down the line you might repent. Somewhere down the line you might say, God, forgive me. There are going to be some people in heaven that you didn't think was going to be there because they called out on that name and they got their heart right with Him. There's some going to be there, glory to God, that you thought in a million years it wouldn't be, and there's going to be some that's not going to be there that you thought for sure would be. Oh, come on. There's a difference calling out, Lord, Lord, and wanting to change than calling out, Lord, Lord, just to be calling out, Lord, Lord. Bitterness, envy, strife, anger, all are traits of a self-righteous spirit. Let's let God clean us up. Then we can help somebody else. Correction, sure. I believe God brings the correction. But He'll bring correction with love. It'll be a spirit of humbleness, a spirit of meekness and love. It won't be a self-righteous snake spirit.
Why do you call it?
Because it spits poison. Poison. When it strikes, brother, it's poison. Come on. I feel this tonight. Somebody needs this. Maybe I need it. Come on. A snake, a lady told me before church tonight, Sister Susan, she called me. She said a snake could strike at anything.
Yep.
It'll strike at anything and inject poison. Come on. It don't care if it's holy or unholy or what. It'll strike at it, brother. See, God gave me some. He gave me a gift to see some things. Let me tell you, it's time that we cut that off. Stop letting them snakes strike at you. Cut them off. We don't have to allow them to inject venom into us, Sister Mary. We can cut it off. You don't like how I'm either? Fine. Go pray about it. Come on. You don't like how I do things? Fine. Go pray about it. But don't try to destroy someone.
Amen.
Because that's not God. Mm-hmm. It's not God, Bobby. When you try to destroy a brother or a sister in Christ, that's not God. That's the devil. That's the work of the devil. Come on. I just feel this in my spirit coming forward tonight, and I'm obeying the Lord. I can't help who it makes mad, who it offends. That's fine. Whatever, take it up with Jesus. Take it up with Jesus. But it's time that we repent and start acting like the children of God instead of a bunch of devils running around. Come on. Destroying each other. Ripping each other apart. Injecting venom. What does the Bible say about the tongue? Huh? I think it's over in the book of James. If I'm not mistaken here. It speaks of the tongue. James chapter 3. Let's read it just a moment. James chapter 3, first verse. My brethren, be not many masters, knowing that we shall receive the greater condemnation. For in many things we offend all. If any man offend not in word, the same as a perfect man, and able also to bridle the whole body. Behold, we put bits in the horses' mouths that they may obey us, and we turn about their whole body. Behold also the ships, which though they be so great are driven of fierce winds, yet are they turned about with a very small hymn, whithersoever the governor listeth. Even so the tongue is a little member and boasteth great things. Behold, how great a matter a little fire kindleth. Here's what the Bible says about the tongue. And the tongue is a fire. A world of iniquity. So is the tongue among our members. Come on. That it defileth the whole body, setteth on fire the course of nature, and it is set on fire of hell. Of hell.
For every kind of beast and the birds and the serpents and the things in the sea is tamed and hath been tamed to mankind. But the tongue can no man tame. It is an unruly evil full of deadly poison. Oh, deadly poison. It'll destroy you. Destroy ministries. Destroy churches. Destroy brothers and sisters in Christ. Poison. Now here is what he said. Therewith bless we God, even the Father, and therewith curse we men, which are made after the similitude of God. Out of the same mouth proceedeth the blessings and cursings. My brethren, these things are not so to be. How can we bless God and then curse our brother? How can I say, oh, I'm so holy and I'm so righteous and I'm walking up right before God, but I'm cursing you? It can't be like that. Sister Mary, I can't serve God and curse you. I can't serve God and curse you, Bobby. I can't speak destruction and death upon you. That's the devil. There's no death in Jesus. There's only life. Death is in the devil. I preached it last night. Life and death is in the power of the tongue. This right here, when you speak life according to His Word, you're speaking life. But when you speak death, you're giving the devil right. You're giving him words to run with. You're giving him what he needs to destroy someone. Death is not in Christ. Jesus is life. He is life. Death is in the devil. Come on now. I feel this so strong tonight, brother. He said, doth the fountain send forth at the same place sweet water and bitter? No, it does not. It'll be one or the other. One or the other, brother. Amen. Can the fig tree, my brethren, bear olive berries, either vine figs? So can no fountain both yield salt water and fresh? He's making a point here. These things can't be coming out of you. Blessings and cursings. Blessing God, cursing man. Blessing God, cursing man. It's made after the similitude of God. It cannot be, and you be a child of God. There's too much hate and destruction in the body of Christ. We are destroying and devouring one another, and the devil's having him a heyday. Right when you get close to that point that God's fixing to send a mighty revival, the devil raises his head up in somebody's flesh. Then there goes that poisonous tongue. The Bible said it. It said it's set on fire of hell. Huh? How many church splits have you seen over the years, brother? I've seen a lot. I've been in a lot. And you want to know something? 9 times out of 10, it was because of a wagging tongue.
Yep.
It really weren't nothing that happened, brother. Just somebody wanted to start talking. Wouldn't even be no truth to what they were even saying. Or a half-truth. A half-truth is a whole lie. I don't care what you say. Amen? Feel the anointing, amen. Thank you, Jesus. He said, who is a wise man endued with knowledge among you? And that was a question. Who's a wise man endued with knowledge among you? He asked him, and it was a question. He said, let him shew out of the good conversation his works with meekness of wisdom. Don't be spewing off at the mouth with a bunch of foolishness. Don't be spewing off with the mouth with a bunch of craziness. Let it be with meekness. Let it be with wisdom. Not many use wisdom anymore. Come on now. They don't use wisdom. But he said this. Next verse. But if you have bitter envy and strife in your hearts, glory not and lie not against the truth. Huh? But this wisdom that is from above is first pure. Huh? Well, let's back up just a moment. 16th verse. For where envy and strife is, there is confusion in every evil work. That's the 16th verse. Where there's envy and strife at, there's confusion in every evil work. If there's always envy, there's always strife, there's confusion, and every evil work that can take place will be there. Didn't say one evil work. He said every evil work. Come on now. But wisdom that is from above, from Jesus, that wisdom he said to share, huh? That wisdom he said to show, huh? Is first pure and easy to be entreated and full of what? Mercy. Huh? And good fruits. Without partiality. Without hypocrisy. And the fruit of righteousness is sown. Now this verse right here we need to grab a hold of. And the fruit of righteousness is sown in peace of them that make peace. 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 That's all I desire is peace. I don't like drama. I don't like confusion. I don't like arguing. I don't like fussing. I don't like none of that dealing because it's out of hell. But peace comes from Jesus. Hallelujah. It comes from Him and that's what I like. I hope somebody got something out of the Word tonight. I know it's a short message, not a spit and holler, jump up and down, but let me tell you something. Let's do our best to walk upright and let's love one another and not destroy one another and falsely accuse. You know, the Lord does not like one that bears a false witness. He's not pleased with that. They bear false witness against Him at Calvary. They lied on Jesus. Of course, it's going to happen to us because they lied on Him. They persecuted Him. They mocked Him. They done everything ungodly they could to bring false accusations. So it's going to happen to us. And let's keep a right heart. Let's keep a right spirit. Let's keep a right mindset. And let's stop letting the devil get in here. He goes in here and into there, through there, into there. Come on. That's his gateways, brother. Here, here, there. That's how he gets in there. Then he starts playing his games. He starts putting all that garbage in your head. He starts battling you. And if you ain't careful, you'll start listening to the lies that he's telling you. You'll start believing the lies that he's telling you about you. You want to know what God thinks about you tonight? Read his word and you'll find out what he thinks about you. He said you're the head, not the tail. You're the lender, not the borrower. You're the apple of his eye. Come on now. You're the apple of his eye. The thoughts that he has toward you are good thoughts. He has an expected end for you and I. Brother, you don't see where I am right now. See, God sees the ending at the beginning. He sees who he's predestinated and ordained you to be. He knows before the foundation of this world the plan that he had for your life. You're not an accident. There's no human being on the face of this earth that's an accident. they were predestinated by him before the foundation of this world was even created. No accident. Just get your mind in him. Get your mind on him. I read a little article from a prophet last night, and I thought it interesting, but what we call deja vu or whatever, and the, you know, he said that was come from a heathen word, but he said it's actually at that moment in time, because God has us predestinated, it's actually in that moment in time that we're in his will. It feels like we've been there before, because that's what he had predestinated. And right then, we're in his perfect will. That's the reason why it feels like I've been here. This is happening. This is, you ever had that happen?
Yeah.
Huh? It's like it's, I lived this. That was his plan. That's the reason he built, because he put it inside of you before you was even birthed. When he formed you, he put that within you. Your destiny is carried on the inside. Woo, I feel it. What he has for you is already in there. And the devil don't want you to birth it. He don't want you to birth it forth. That's the reason why he's taking side blinding everybody and doing everything that he can to get everybody's eyes off of Jesus, because the closer we get to birth in that, Sister Mary, the closer we become more conformed to his son, who we are predestinated to be conformed as. So he'll try to sidetrack you, buddy. See how so-and-so looked at you at church. Well, they don't like you. Come on. So-and-so might have been having a bad day. So-and-so maybe have been sitting there listening to the same spirits telling them. You see how they looked at you? Come on now, folks. Anything that he can do, anything, to get our eyes off of the Lord. See, my eyes is more on the battle than it is Jesus, then I'm in trouble. Huh? If it's more on the battle than it is Jesus, then I'm in trouble. I'm fighting in the dark. Because as that old song goes, he's the lighthouse. He's our light. I think I preached myself tonight. And he's awesome. Let's just get our eyes on him. There may be things take place when we leave here tonight, but let's just walk it. Let's just walk it. Don't let it get your eyes off of him. Amen. Well, praise the Lord. Give the Lord a big old hand clap of praise tonight. Amen. Do you love him tonight? Hallelujah. I've enjoyed being here tonight. And glory to God. Just be praying for the churches. And thank you, Jesus. And be praying for us. And, the 13th, I got a feeling for Sister Susan on the radio broadcast. So be praying about that. Amen. And if you want to go with me. Amen. I can use singers. Amen. And just continue praying about everything. Amen. Praise the Lord. Give the Lord a big old hand clap of praise. Does anybody have a need tonight? We'd be glad to pray for you. Anybody tonight? It'll take a little bit for these mics to get as oily as another, but it'll happen. Praise the Lord. Well, if nobody has a need, Lord of God, I'll let you all go. And just may the Lord keep you, protect you, and watch over you until we all meet again. God bless you each and every one.